On another note, it is Wednesday, which means it's time to check in with our book critic, Gwen Reyes, and she's got a special pick for the week. Gwen, tell us about it.
I do. It has nothing to do with William Shatner, okay, though, unfortunately. But this one we have is called Rules Do Not Apply.
I like the title.
It's a great title. It kind of gives you a hint of what's to come. Mm-hmm. However, it's a very depressing, sad
is
read.
It really?
Yes, it's a memoir by Ariel Levy, who is a New York, she writes for The New Yorker.
Okay.
She went off to Mongolia to do an assignment. Pregnant, married, had a beautiful house. Within a month of being in Mongolia, she actually lost her baby.
Wow.
Her marriage fell apart and she lost her home.
That's awful.
All very
tragedy within a short amount of time.
And then she weaves the story in her memoir of like how all that happened and how she's dealing with her own grief. So it's perfect for readers who really loved Cheryl Strand's Wild, which was made into a movie with Reese Witherspoon.
Okay.
But it's just a really heartfelt, deep, but also brutally depressing memoir.
So is this really about kind of showing all of this awful tragedy, but then trying to wrap it up with a bow, or is it really methods of helping you get through your own personal tragedy?
I think it was more methods of getting through her own personal tragedy, because at the end of the book, she's still not quite dealing with everything that's happening. She's accepted that it's all happened, but she still kind of is reflecting on, well, maybe these greedy choices that I made, maybe the fact that I chose my career over my own future.
Trying to make sense of
Yes, trying
the
to make sense of things
happened.
That she really couldn't control. Her doctors in her life told her she couldn't control that. Everybody in her life told her she couldn't control it. But it's still such a wrenching read, and I think that a lot of women, especially working women, will find something in it.
Yeah, that's honest. I mean, when things don't go right, we are trying to make sense of it, you know, blame people or circumstances. And a lot of times, like you say, it's just the way that
Some
it is.
Just happen, and
so
unfortunately,
a lot of people can likely relate to that.
Yes, absolutely. So the book is out now, and it's a really, really riveting read.
That's just incredible. I mean, abroad too.
Yeah, away from her family.
Yeah.
She chose to be this correspondent, so it's got this like fun sort of adventure element to it. But at the same time, she finds the punishment in that adventure and that choice. So she feels there's this weight and cloud over the entire book where she is feeling so guilty and so responsible for the choices that she made. But unfortunately, she was just trying to do the best thing that she could, and she couldn't have helped anything that happened to her.
Well, I hope there is at least a little bit of clarity by the end of the book?
Yes.
Okay.
Definitely
so
clarity and definitely some happy writing that came from it.
All right, a deep one. Gwen, thank you so
Thanks,
much
Alicia.
For that. Really appreciate it. Jason will send